In our next segment, we'll see how Retrovi is helping couples who are facing difficult challenges in their marriage restore their marriage and rebuild a loving relationship. Joining me now to discuss the ministry in greater detail, it's a pleasure to welcome Phil and Sue Milazzo, who are community coordinators for Retrovi. Phil, first question, for the benefit of people who may not be all that familiar with this new ministry, how would you describe Retrovi?
Retrovi is was started as a French-speaking program in Canada and was eventually translated into English. It is basically for people who are suffering a crisis in their marriage. I mean, they're in the middle of the crisis, or they may even be separated or divorced, but there is enough there that they think they want to try again. And this weekend is designed just for people like that.
Sue, as I understand that the couples who are actually facilitating the Retrovi weekend are couples who themselves have gone through difficult times with their marriage. Was that the case for you and Phil?
Yes, definitely. We were headed for divorce when we went on a Retrovi weekend. We were married for about 15 years at the time, and things seemed to be okay, you know, but something was missing, and we both knew it. But things got worse and worse, and we just didn't know how to make them better. And I guess for myself, I kind of figured that this is the way marriage is. You know, it's not always rosy, and it's not always going to be exciting like it was at the beginning. But I think we were both unhappy, and we just didn't know where to go, where to turn for help.
And that unhappiness led to other things. Eventually, it led to my poor choice of becoming involved with another woman. And just not even bad enough that I got close to another woman and was emotionally involved with her. We became physical and intimate with each other also. And that decision led us down the path of lawyers and separation and divorce, things like that.
It was very shocking for me when I heard that there was someone else. I wasn't surprised because things weren't that good. But I really didn't think we were going to stop loving each other like it had. I ran in circles trying to find something to help us, to try to turn things around, try to make some sense out of what was happening, and try to work on a marriage. And I had no help at all. No matter where I went, people were helping me get divorced, but no one was helping me stay married. That was until we found out about Retrovi.
Phil, I'm sure there's someone watching this interview today. They're probably going through their own difficult times with their marriage, wondering where to go, who to turn to. How does Retrovi help a couple that is struggling rebuild that relationship?
Basically, the communication technique that we use is the communication of feelings. Feelings are a large part of the program because feelings cannot be judged as right or wrong. They just are. Whereas our thoughts, our opinions, we can argue with. And that's probably what we've been doing a lot of once we come to that point. We've been having a lot of thoughts and opinions that we've been arguing with. But feelings can't be argued with. And it's a series of writing for ourselves and for the other person also, where we write, we listen to a presentation, a question is presented at the end of that presentation, and then we are to write in a notebook our answers. And the questions are designed to bring out our feelings. And as I said, we can't really argue with our feelings, and that's what we teach the people, is that we have to accept each other's feelings because they aren't right or wrong. And we find that over the course of a weekend, that acceptance of feelings, especially people will not really understand that their spouse felt a certain way about certain situations because we really don't speak these things to each other. We just kind of either bury it or get into an argument because we're using our thoughts and our opinions to say things instead of our feelings.
And this technique of communication is very non-threatening. We write it in a notebook and we separate to write, so we're not disturbed by the other person or how much they're writing or what they're writing. So we come together and share our thoughts with each other. Like I say, it's very non-threatening because you're not being judged by what you're saying or arguing is not a part of Retrovi.
Hopefully not.
Touching upon that point, there may be someone watching this today who's a little bit reticent about getting involved because they're afraid of having to bare their soul in front of a group of people. But RetroVi isn't about that.
There is no group sharing unless you want to. There is a couple of points on the weekend where if someone would like to share, we invite them to. But no one is ever forced to say anything about their relationship. You could go through the entire weekend and not even say why you were there.
Sue, looking at the team that will be facilitating the weekend, tell me a little bit about the makeup of that team.
Well, it's three married couples and a priest presenting the weekend. And each married couple has been through some type of crisis in their own relationship. Just as many different teams we have, there's many different crises in a relationship. Marriages fall apart for all different reasons. Each weekend is different because it's made up of different teams, so.
Yeah, we know, we have other couples that we've known who have had gambling addictions in their relationship, alcohol addiction in their relationship, lots of various different things.
Sue, there's only so much you can accomplish over the course of a weekend. What kind of follow-up is involved with RetroVi?
Well, we have six follow-up sessions that starts the week after the weekend, and we go through the same
same concepts
of the weekend, and we go in a little more depth and a little more I guess everyday type of things too.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then there's also a monthly program?
There is a monthly program for people who would like to be included in that. It's called CORE, Continuing Our RetroVi Experience. And that experience is where five or six couples maybe would meet in each other's homes on a monthly basis. One of the couples would do a presentation from an outline that we can supply to them. There would be a question at the end of those presentations that the couples are invited to write about. And again, they would share those feelings that they've written down. And then there's also time in a group like that for socializing. Once that is all done, the couples can get a lot closer to each other by talking about their everyday lives and things that are going on with them.
Sue, you and Phil are basically starting from scratch in resurrecting this RetroVi program. What do you need in terms of help in order to get this off the ground?
We need people. We need people to do prayer letters, people to do hosting, people to just get supplies and get them together, set up for the weekend, take down the banners. And
yeah, we have another couple making banners for us, there's medicinal supplies that we like to keep there in case anybody forgot anything when they came to the weekend. That stuff all needs to be bought. Notebooks, pens, other kinds of propaganda that we use. So there's a lot of stuff that we got to kind of spread around.
And I think hopefully we hope that someone would come on and be a team. Anyone is invited to do that if they choose. So, I mean, there's no rules or regulations. It's just a wanting to share, a wanting to give back. And that's how we got involved, because we would not be sitting here today together if it wasn't for RetroVi.
And Phil, is RetroVi available to couples who are going through a divorce or a separation?
Most definitely. Most definitely. It's happened many times.
And we've been gifted to see people get back together after being divorced.
When you reflect back on your own personal experience with RetroVi over the last several years, how blessed do you feel to have had this ministry in your lives?
More grateful than we can even say, really. As Sue said, if not for that program, we would not be sitting here today. And we've had that reflected back to us from many, many couples over the years that we have presented weekends to. They've said to us, if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here today. Some of our closest friends on Long Island have told us that many times. And it's just been a blessing that we've been able to do something with the terrible thing that happened to us.
This little non-threatening way of communicating changed our lives. Mm. It brought us back to why we got married, why we fell in love, and almost rediscovered each other all over again. In fact, the word RetroVi means to rediscover. But RetroVi saved us, and it saved our family. And we are so grateful as we are blessed to see our children and our grandchildren. That still would have happened, but we wouldn't have enjoyed it together.
Wouldn't have been the same, no.
No.